The game certainly didn't go our way. With 5.5 minutes left, I decided to get some of our depth guys into the game, give them an opportunity to compete. I'm very proud of how they went in there. Bruce Brown led that group, and it was I think it got to be a 20 or 21 or 2 point lead for them. And, you know, we got to cut to 10, and it forced them to put their starters back in the game. And I'm just proud of the way those guys competed. I like the way we competed tonight. We just didn't play well. It wasn't our night. What happened after the game was unfortunate. There was a misunderstanding about the game ball. It was Oscar Tshiebwe's first NBA official point, so we always get the game ball. We were not thinking about Giannis's franchise record, so we grabbed the ball and. A couple of minutes later, several of their players ended up in our hallway, and there was a fracas, melee, whatever. I don't think any punches were landed, but my general manager got elbowed in the ribs by one of their players, and. So he certainly has a bruised rib, and who knows, you know, if it's anything more than that. But unfortunate situation. We don't need the official game ball. There's two game balls there. You know, we could have taken the other one, but it didn't need to escalate to that. And so, you know, really just, you know, unfortunate. Third game we played these guys within 2.5-3 weeks. So things are heated with the competition. And, you know, I understand all that. But for it to come into the hallway didn't need to happen that way.
Just to get a little bit more detail there, I'm sorry. How did it escalate? I mean, I think.
I'm not sure. I'm just explaining what happened. I mean, there's people tweeting things out there. I'm telling you exactly what happened. I'm not naming names, but I think it's pretty clear, you know, who was involved. And look, it's just, you know, thing ended up being a three-hour game, you know, with all the things going on and a zillion free throws and all that. And, you know, just too much, you know.
Just to clarify, you said that your guy's PM was elbowed by a Bucks player?
Don't know who. I don't know who. I'm not naming any names. I'm just telling you what happened. There were four or five of their guys in our hallway, you know? So, anyway, just stuff that doesn't need to happen. You know, the thing with the ball is just, I mean... We don't care that much about the official game ball and, you know, all that kind of stuff. I mean, but anyway, unfortunately, that'll be a bigger story than the game.
The ball was a tipping point, but, I mean, you had bad blood or whatever because of the competition level and familiarity and getting tired of seeing each other. Did that all feed into that moment, you figured?
I can't speak in detail on that because I can't read minds. So, but the words unfortunate and unnecessary, I keep repeating. You know, so I think that's explains enough. A lot of things, unfortunate, unnecessary.
Were you at all surprised that when you pulled your guys out that they left their starters in for as long as they did? Was that, or did you kind of want that so that you had the opportunity to put Jarris and Ben and Oscar in those situations against those guys?
No point commenting on it. I think it's pretty obvious what the answer is.
What obviously in the midst of that, Giannis goes off for.
What's that?
Obviously, before all this, Giannis, of course, 64, you obviously spoke in the beginning about how great a player he is. I mean, just what, and what makes him difficult. I mean, what made him, I guess, even more special than usual tonight. Prior to all this.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we got to do a better job on him. You know, not going to get into anything about how the game's officiated or any of that stuff. No point. There's no point. I mean, you know, people at the league office will see this in HD, as will everyone else. You know. We had a rough night. They had a great night, and you know the thing at the end was unnecessary.
When something like this happens, how do you kind of approach that as a coach? Do you address it? Do you just kind of let it go? Like I just curious, how do you kind of address that?
It's none of your business.
Okay. I guess what happened? The Aaron Flagrant, was that just a heat?
I was a little confused on it. I thought he grabbed him and tried to hold him up. I was confused on that, and I was also confused on the Bobby Portis play where he broke Isaiah Jackson's nose, and it was called a good basket. So. But you know, we'll find out. We can, if we want, we can submit that stuff to the league and get an explanation. But you know, officials, they're trying hard. They're not perfect. So I'm not gonna kill those guys. I mean,
Isaiah has a broken nose.
At the time, I thought I'm no doctor. But he was gushing blood out of his nose. And then they finally got it to stop at halftime. But, look, it's just, you're on the road in the Central Division. I mean, this is the way the Central Division was 18 years ago with Indiana and Detroit and Chicago and Cleveland and a lot of competitive teams. And so, you know, this kind of competition is what the NBA should be about to a point, you know. But, you know, these kinds of experiences are experiences our players can learn from because they got to go through these things. You know, for where we aspire to go, you know, the emotions, you know, the physical level, all those kinds of things are things we have to experience. You know, raucous road arenas, all that stuff, you know. And so, you know, it's experience that we will learn from.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.